Hey friends, welcome to another video of Microsoft Office tutorials. Friends, in today's video we are going to learn that how we can prepare such an amazing aging analysis in Microsoft Excel that we can customize quickly and easily just by drag and drop. Before we start, I want to make clear that the procedure that we are going to follow or the procedure that we will use in this tutorial, this procedure is same if you want to prepare aging analysis for your stock, aging analysis for your suppliers, or aging analysis for your customers. In my case, I have here sales data or customers data that we are going to use to prepare aging analysis. So obviously we are going to prepare aging analysis for customers in this tutorial. But again, the procedure is same. You can use the same procedure to prepare aging analysis for your stock, for your customers, and for your suppliers. So let's get started. As we said, we have here sales data or customers data that we are going to use to prepare customers aging analysis. In this data, we have here customer names, invoice number, invoice date, and invoice amount. This is a kind of raw form of data, right, that we are going to use to prepare aging analysis. As this is a kind of raw form of data, so we need to do some working on this data to prepare aging analysis. So what we will do, we will add here three helping columns. In first column, we need to find out due date of each invoice. Obviously, we cannot prepare aging analysis if we don't know the due date of invoices, right? So what we will do here, for sake of understanding, we suppose that there are 30 days that if an invoice is issued after 30 days, that invoice becomes due. So to find due date, we will simply add invoice date plus 30. After invoice date, as after 30 days of invoice date, invoice becomes due. So we will simply add 30 into invoice date. So here we go. We will just simply drag it down. And now for all invoices, we have here due date. So now next step is, here we need to find out our due days. Our due days meaning that as of today, there are how many days that each invoice has become due. As of today, meaning we will use here today's date. To insert here today's date, we will use here today function minus due date. Today function will provide us today's date. And now we are going to minus due date from today's date. We will insert here, enter, we will press enter. And now it is giving us number of days. Just we need to change here format into general. And this is number of days 345. So we will just drag it down. And now for each invoice we have here our due days. If we come down, you can see here the number of days or the result is in minus. We know that number of days or days can never ever be in minus. So why it is giving us the result in minus? Because here you can see due date is 18 January 2021, but today is 14 January. So therefore it is giving us result is in minus 4. So we need to resolve this issue. To resolve this issue, we will add here that if result is in minus, we want here 0 simply. So what we will do to insert this thing, that if result is in minus, we want here 0. We will insert here if formula. In if formula, we will insert that if result of this formula is less than 0. Less than 0 meaning the figure or result is in negative. Then what we want here 0. Otherwise, what we want, otherwise we don't want to do anything. Otherwise, we want here same formula. So we will press enter, we will just drag it down. Now if I come down, it will give result as 0, because if result is in minus, we want here 0 simply. So now next thing, the next thing is we will add here categories of aging. So let me just add here, then we can discuss this. So here 0, 1, 31, 61, 91 maybe, 121. So here not due yet, 1 to 30 days, 31 to 60 days, 61 to 90 days, 91 to 120 days, and above 120 days. So this is categories of aging. I hope that you would have been understood this thing, that the same thing that we see here, this is the category of aging. Not you yet 1 to 30, 31 to 60, 61 to 90, 91 to 120 and above 120. So now we need to connect these overdue days with this category. So for this, we will just add here maybe status of invoice. So here we need to bring status of invoice as per our categories. So we will use here simply we lookup function based on this. We will just select this. We want to look up this value from this table, comma, and we want to bring result from second column. So in place of column index number, we will insert here 2, then comma, and here we need to use approximate match, and here we go. Status of this invoice is, this is overdue above 120 days. So we will just lock this range. So we have been locked this range so that when we drag this formula down, this range also don't become down. So we will press enter, and here I will just drag it down. I will press 2 times here, and you can see here now we have status of our invoices. Now we need to add such an aging analysis table. So this is very simple and very easy. We will just go to insert tab. In insert tab, we will go to pivot table, and it will select the whole table. And we want to insert the whole table or pivot table in new sheet. We will go for OK. And here we have pivot table. So we will simply insert here customer name in rows field. Let's say we want to know how much amount is due from each customer. We will drop this amount field in values. You can see total amount due from each customer this. Now as we want to make aging analysis, so we will simply status of invoice, as we know that we have here status of invoice. In header of status of invoice, we can see above 120 or 91 to 120. So we will just pick the status of invoice and we will drop in columns, and here we go. You can see here 1 to 30, 31 to 60, we can just arrange this order. We will bring here. So not due yet, 1 to 30 days old, 31 to 60 days, 61 to 90, 91 to 20, about 120 days. So you can also manage, or you can also change these categories of aging as per your requirement. So friends, that's all. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to give thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel, Microsoft Office Tutorials. Also, don't forget to share this knowledge with your friends. Thanks for watching. See you in next video. Bye-bye.